We'll be starting with the SMILE webcast. We are planning to do SMILE. So, Dr. Amrita, if you can show us the patient's data, that will be nice.
So, I can see Dr. Nivin here. We welcome Nivin here.
Is my screen visible? Hello, everyone.
You have to go to screen slide slow show, please.
Okay, sir.
So,
now?
Yes, please. Can you please tell us about the patient, Dr. Amrita? So we are planning to do a SMILE procedure here.
Yes. Good morning, everyone. Here we are starting a live surgery session from Drishti Eye Institute, Dehradun. So the patient that we're planning for the refractive surgery is a 27-year female who's been using spectacles since past 15 years. She's a nurse by profession and is an occasional contact lens user. She's been using the acceptance of -2.75 with -1.75 of cylinder at 80 degree of axis in her right eye, and the left eye has -3.25 along with -1.25 at 100 degree of axis. These are the pentacam maps that I want to share. So we can actually see the central corneal thickness is 493 in right eye and 490 in the left eye. And the K readings are also quite consistent. We can't see any like outliners or any red flags into it. This is the balance I want to show. So this is for the right eye that we're seeing, the front elevation and the back elevation maps. Along with this, these are the left eye maps that we have.
I'll be watching your eye first.
We also have the epithelial maps for the for both the eyes. So we have the 486 of the corneal thickness here along with the OCT to be normal. And for the left eye, we have 483 corneal thickness and the OCT looks normal. So over to Dr. Gaurav for starting his live surgery for SMILE for this particular patient.
Thanks, Dr. Amrita. So I think we are all set. Patient is ready. She is a nurse herself, and she is kindly consented to be, part of this live surgery program. So I think the crucial thing is we are using the Visumax laser, which is we've been using for about 4 or 5 years now. And as Dr. Tityal said, we are also now doing predominantly SMILE, although I also do contura LASIK in good number of patients. For this patient, we chose SMILE. As you could see that the corneal thickness was about 493. Our cutoff for SMILE is about 490. And in these patients, because her correction is just about 3.5 diopters with 1.5 cylinder, we decided to go with a SMILE procedure. Can you look into the light, please? So first thing to do is to make sure it, what's different with LASIK is that here we want the cornea to be nice and wet, but the conjunctiva to be dry because this is a corneal suction. And patients are very comfortable throughout the procedure. Can you look into the light, please? Yeah, keep watching. So I'm now going to soak on the all the extra fluid on the conjunctiva. So I hope my surgical screen is visible to you now. Microscope view. So we have to ensure that the conjunctiva is nice and dry, but the cornea remains wet. So we take extra precautions because this is a much gentler suction than happens with most other femtosecond lasers. And patient is actually able to see and fixate. I'm in fact joined here by Dr. Himanshu Mehta as well, who's standing by me to observe, and he's visiting us from Bombay. He'll be operating later on in the day, so we'll take some expert comments from him. Now, once we've done that, we've already primed our cone for the interface for the SMILE procedure, and now I've dried up the conjunctiva, but now I'm going to wet the cornea to make sure that the cornea remains wet. One second. So I'll have to focus. So once that is focused, we are all set. We've already primed the pack and now we'll be going on with the second step of the procedure. So now you'll be able to see a small green light. So you have to look into the green light. So the most important part of doing SMILE is to keep talking to the patient and guiding them what to expect. And that's what we normally do. So I'm going to be talking to the patient and we can all keep hearing. Aapko na upar choti si green light dikhegi. उसी के अंदर देखना है वो ब्लिंक करती रहेगी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू काउंट टिल 10 टिल 20 यू विल बी एबल टू सी द ग्रीन लाइट टिल द काउंट ऑफ 10 एंड यू हैव टू ओनली लुक एट दैट ग्रीन लाइट वंस आई क्रॉस द पॉइंट ऑफ काउंट ऑफ 10 द ग्रीन लाइट विल बिकम ब्लरी बट एट दैट टाइम देन इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू रिमेन रिलैक्स्ड एंड कीप लुकिंग स्ट्रेट अप एज यू आर लुकिंग नाउ सो आई एम काउंटिंग टिल 20 नाउ प्लीज कीप वॉचिंग द स्मॉल ग्रीन लाइट एंड रिलैक्स 1 2 three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now you won't see the green light, so remain relaxed and keep both eyes open and keep looking straight up. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So we are, that's the ablation done. So we are using a port of 2 millimeters, and you can as you would like. For comfort, initially when I started, I used to use a 4 mm side cut, and we are used a 6.3 millimeters optical zone with a 7.3 total zone for this patient. And now you have to look into the light. So now I'll be dissecting the two planes. Essentially, how SMILE is different from LASIK, as we all understand, is that, you know, we don't have a flap, and that is probably the key to all the benefits which accrue from SMILE. So now I'm first identifying the deeper plane, and once that is, and you could see that the OBL was escaped, and this is the sign which Dr. Sheetal has described when you have a good sudden escape of that plane. Now the second plane, which is the superficial plane, so I've identified the cap now. And all surgeons prefer to first dissect the cap. So here we are going to dissect the cap first. And for a LASIK surgeon to switch to SMILE is much easier than it is for a person who has not done femtoflaps initially. Now I've entered the second plane. So now I'm dissecting the deeper plane. And once I've dissected the deeper plane, I will now break through for the side cuts of the lenticule, first of all at 6 o'clock position, and then progressively to the sides, and then identifying on the other two sides and leaving a small frill of attached island of lenticule on each side, which I now break through. So now the section is complete on the right side, and now I complete it to the left side. So now my lenticule is free floating inside. I'm pretty sure that the lenticule has been dissected. Now I'll be using a new technique which I devised a few years back. Most people would remove this lenticule with a forceps. I like to do a hydro expression. Although I can nowadays remove the lenticule just with my dissector itself most of the times. But for a beginner surgeon, it would be really nice to use this hydro expression cannula. This cannula has been devised by me in collaboration with Epsilon. So you can see that the lenticule is being expressed out with the gush of fluid, and it's mostly out. I'm doing it very gently. If you push the fluid very fast, it'll just come out very fast and then flow away. So now we've got the lenticule out. It's a very atraumatic way of expressing the lenticule using hydro expression, and this cannula is specially designed, as you can see. It goes with the contour of the cornea and gushes fluid at 6 o'clock, and the lenticule will pop out just like SICS, the nucleus pops out. So you can see here that the lenticule, one has to check and make sure the lenticule is complete from all sides so that you don't have any retained lenticule. And once you're sure of that, you can discard the lenticule, and then you can remove the excess fluid from the pocket. So usually patients are very, very comfortable, and the procedure is very quick. Usually within 2 to 3 minutes, the procedure is over. And most patients on day one start seeing 6-6 as well. With patients with high astigmatism, we use cyclotorsion control, and we mark the axis as well. And Dr. Sheetal can probably tell us a little bit more about it. So this was I'm only planning to show you one eye so that we can have some discussion. And the procedure is now complete. We can use the slit to examine the interface for looking for any debris, or even if you want to inspect. So the Visumax has been very good for doing flaps as well. And we have been using this for SMILE for a good number of years now. And the results are excellent, and patient satisfaction is very good. I'll be happy to answer any questions.